Hello friends, welcome to System Admin tutorial. Today we discuss about the free tool that is Nagios. Nagios is a tool which is used for the monitoring purpose. By using this Nagios tool, we can ping the host or remote system so that we can check whether the server is live or dead, whether it is connected to the network or not, from how many times it is connected or disconnected, what is the log time, everything we can get by using this Nagios tool. Okay, so how to configure this Nagios, we'll check. Okay, here the some basic packages required before going for the Nagios installation. You have to install this, that is the HTTPD, PHP, PHP CLI and GCC and libc, libc common. These are the some packages, you just note it down from the screen itself. Okay, so by using the yum command, you have to install all these on your system. Okay, all the packages are downloading from yum repository. Now it is asking for the confirmation and clicking here yes. Once all the installation completes, then we can move further for the other package installation, that is development tools and all, and Nagios packages. And where you have to download the Nagios packages, everything I will be providing in the description itself. You see, all the 16 packages downloaded, and after that it is installing one by one. You can see the number of installation, 1 of 16, 2 of 16, 3 of 16, like this it will move towards to 16 by 16. The process is very easy. Now I am doing it on our CentOS system. For Ubuntu, you can also find the steps at our site, that is systemadmintutorial.com. From there, you will search Nagios in the search bar, then you will easily find the complete step for the Ubuntu. See, my last package is installing, that is GCC. Everything still completed. I clear the screen. Now you have to install the group package, that is yum group. My development tools are getting installed. Everything will be installed here. Group install is a command to install everything. Means we have to define the group, that is the development tools. For that, all the groups packages will be installed by using the group install command. All my 41 packages are in the installation phase. There are a lot of monitoring tools we are using or automation tools that are like Nagios. In previous lecture, I also have demonstrated how to install the Ansible. In the upcoming lecture, we will also see how to install the Ceph, which is an automation tool used for the installation of the packages on different client systems. It is used in the DevOps environment. In the DevOps, you will be familiar with the Ansible, Ceph. Lot of tools are there. So these are one by one, I will get through all the installation phases of all the tools. Everything completed. Now clear the screen. Okay. Now you have to restart the service. Service HTTP start. Okay, HTTP is the service for the web page or for Apache. If you are running the Apache, then HTTP is the service. Okay, so you have to make it permanent by using the check and tick. Now we have to add a group for the Nagios user. Let it be XAMD. Okay. Now we have to change the user into that group. This is the single command. By using this user mode command, we can add A is the parameter or the syntax used to add the or append the user into that group. G is capital G is used for the group. So group is the next name and we are adding the user that is Nagios. Nagios, okay. Now it is added. If we'll check the Nagios user, then it will be the part of the NagsMD group. I will check. Let's add another user, that is Apache is a default user, it's already there. So also add the same Apache user into the NagsMD group. After that, we'll see. By showing the password folder, it is the password you can see. You see, in the last line, you can find the Nagios user with the home directory Nagios. Okay. And Apache is also there. You can see there is another user. Apache is also there, but that user does not have any login. And here also, Nagios, we have provided the complete address to this Nagios user. Okay, so clear the screen. Now you have to move into the here. You see, some of the Nagios packages are already downloaded. Here, you see, in the desktop, you can see the Nagios login is there and Nagios 4.4 package is already downloaded. It is in the tar format. Okay, we have to extract it by using tar-xvm. Okay, so for that it is available in the desktop, so we have to change the directory to the desktop. You can see by using the cd command, I'm changing the directory. Okay, here you have to see ls is there. Here two tar files are available, so I have to extract the tar file. I will extract by using the tar command. XVF, okay, XVF is the flag which is used for the extraction. V means verbose, F means forcefully. Okay, Nagios, we have to give the 4.4, that is the tar file. Okay, it is extracted completely. Here on the desktop, you can also see if I will list the directory, I can find the extract directory, that is Nagios 4.4.5. okay, so now I have to change the directory to the extracted directory that is Nagios 4.4.5. Okay, so I'll by using the Nagios. Already I am in the desktop directory. So by using okay, and then ls, a lot of files are there. Clear the screen. Once the screen clear, the shortcut for clear the screen is Ctrl L. If you press the Ctrl L, instead of writing the clear command, you can directly clear the screen. Okay, so now we are in the directory that is Nagios 4.4.5. So how to configure this? So dot slash configure. Here this is the command used, configure. It is already there in the script, so no need to worry about it. Okay, this is the command. We have to use the command group name, that is nagcmd. Okay, have to use the accurate command whatever I am using, otherwise the configuration will not succeed, you will get the error. Okay, everything is there. You can see the what is the HTML URL I am getting, that is http://localhost/nagios. This is the URL through which we will able to access our tool from the web browser. Okay, I'll check it in the later page after adding the some of the host or number of hosts into the configuration file. So before that, the configuration is ready. So now we have to change whatever the changes we have made, so that we have to reload by using the make command. Make command is used to reload everything, so that whatever changes are there, that can be saved properly. Okay, make all I am doing. So see, once the configuration reloaded properly and everything configured, it will take some time. Everything done successfully. You will see the message is coming in there. So now you have to use another command, that is every time why I am clearing the screen, because whatever the command I am using, it should be visible to you. Now use make install, and everything should be that make command should be run in the that directory, that's Nagios 4.4.5. okay, done. Now you have to make install and pin init. Okay, we have to initialize. It's done. I also provide the command in the description. You can find there from where you have to download the packages and everything. And if you don't find in the description, you just go to our site, that is systemadmintutorial.com, and search for the Nagios, where you will find everything. All the commands are captured there. So from there you can copy and paste to your terminal. Make install. Install the daemon. Okay, init script also installed. Now we have to install, clear the screen, make install config. Okay, config file is also installed. I use the make install command mode. Okay. Okay, external command directory is also configured. Now you have to make install another file, that is exfoliation. Okay, this is the theme. This is the theme we are using. So now you can also use the different theme. A lot of Nagios themes are available on site. You can download that. Okay, now install web configuration. Configuration file installed, that is etc nagios.conf file. Okay, now I have to use password to keep the password. Okay, Nagios admin. New password for the Nagios admin is, I am giving Nagios okay, I have set the password for the Nagios admin user by using the /etc/c, then user local Nagios /etc/etc/password.users, then the username, that is the Nagios admin. Don't you change the Nagios admin user, otherwise you have to change inside the configuration file also. Okay, it is the default username defined in the Nagios, so whatever password you want you can set by using this command. Okay, now we have to restart the service. I will restart by using the service command. You see the HTTPD service restarted successfully, that is okay. Okay, message is coming. So now you have to go to the which one, root desktop, so that the plugin of the Nagios can be installed. Okay, I am there. You see the Nagios plugin is also available, that is Nagios plugin 2.2.1. okay, so you also use the tar-xpf, then plugin. Okay, here you see also the same in the desktop itself, it the Nagios plugin also extracted, so you have to change the directory to the Nagios plugin. Okay, you check where now we are there, we are in the Nagios plugin directory. Okay, so after that you have to also configure the plugin by using the command .configure. Configure is used to run the script file. Nagios is the user. Nagios user is to Nagios is the command to pass the parameter user. again another command that is kiosk-group. Okay, what is the group for this? This is also dagger. Okay, is checking all the parameters. Now everything will be installed. And showing you the complete setup of the Nagios. So you follow all the steps whatever I have done here. If one step is get missed, then it will give a malfunction, so it will not work properly. Everything, all the command to be run on the terminal. Okay, everything completed successfully. Once again, I am showing the what command I have run, that is dot configure inside this Nagios plugin directory. You have to install using the Nagios user as Nagios and Nagios group as the Nagios. Okay, now you have to run the command main, so that whatever changes we have made, that should be synced and reloaded. Okay, you see everything completed. I have to clear the screen. Now I have to make install. This is the last command. After that we have to check whether the configuration run successfully or not. So this is the directory where we have to check whether everything done as per our requirement or not. You have to go to the build directory and then yeah. Okay, give a space, then hyphen V. Okay, now we put the again the which directory, that is local Nagios. Now we have to give the configuration directory, that is etc, then Nagios.cs. This is the directory where we have set the configuration, and all the configuration are stored in this file Nagios.csv file. Okay, so enter. Okay, you see everything is checked successfully and there is no warning. Warning is zero and total errors is zero. Once you get this zero message, means there is no error found. Okay, once you are not finding any error and everything is completed successfully, then you have to restart the service, Nagios service. Okay, so how you have to restart the service? By using the service Nagios restart. Okay, then you have to check the Nagios status. Okay, it is running. Everything, all the steps are same. You have to use in the CentOS 7, 8, whatever you like. But some of the commands, like instead of using service, we will use the systemctl. And these are the some basic OS commands you have to take care. Otherwise, all the make commands and installations are same. Okay. So now we'll check whether we are able to find it or not. Go to the browser. okay, here in the browser you have to okay, by using IP or local host, whatever you want you can give. So let's find the IP of your server, local server, that is 102. Okay, so yeah, I guess we'll check there it is working or not. Okay, asking for the username. So what is the username? Nagas admin. And what is the password we have given? That is okay, password cannot be disclosed. Okay, saving the password here. You see, this is the Nagas interface I am getting. Then I have to click on this host. Okay, so I am finding that only one host is there, that is local host. And the status of the host is up. Okay, so because I have not added any other host into the file, so once I will add the other host name or the IP address of the different servers or the network devices in your premises, whatever the infrastructure you have, whatever the infrastructure or what you want to monitor, then you can add into the configuration file. Okay, I will show you how to add into the configuration file. This is the configuration, everything is working properly. You can see this is the local host. If I click on this, then I can get everything. Okay, what is the IP, what is the information, what is the last check time, everything. Okay, then if you click on the services, then you see all the information are showing here, whatever the basic information you need to check so that your service is live or not, your server is working properly or not. This is a monitoring tool, but it's required for a system admin or a IT guy. Okay, so those are working in the IT infrastructure, everyone should want to use this Nagas tool. Okay, here you see this is the number of host op is one down. If anyone will get down, then here we will see everything. Here the services means that is HTTP, SSH or ping, everything, whatever the services are there, number of services which are working or which is giving a warning, that information will be shown here. Okay, so if I'll add a number host into the configuration file, then here it will increase, the number of host will increase. Okay, we'll see how to add into the configuration. You see where the configuration file lies. Okay, this is a local here you see, this is the directory where the configuration file lies, that is user local Nagas etc Nagas test.cfg. You go there. Okay, you can set the log file where you will store the log, that is log file path is complete, path is given here. Okay, and here you see individual objects and everything, the context cfg, all the details are there. You can see that monitoring local, that is local host is path is also given, that is here you can see the CFG file is user local Nagas etc, then objects, inside that you will find that local host.cfg1 file is there, where you will find the local host name is there. So we will go to that directory, that is the directory. You can also change this path also. Okay, this is objects. Okay, we'll go to this file localhost.cfg and we'll see how to change or provide the name. Okay, if you want to give a different file path, then also you can create the file, and here also you can change the path. Okay, so clear everything. VI is the editor we are using. That is yes, here local. Then you have to go to the objects there. Okay, inside that local host is there. Inside that you have to define your host. Okay, you see the host group is also defined. Everything is there, so I'll only give the ping check now and other services I have not checked. Okay, so here you can find the service syntax. Okay, this is the service syntax. You just copy it, and at the last line giving a bar, and here you have to paste so that I can make changes. Okay, this is the service part. Also we have to get the another syntax, that is host file. You go up the beginning, you will find define host will be there. Here you see this is the service definition part I have copied. You have to go to the host definition. Okay, here paste. Okay, this is the giving the name for identification. New host. Okay, new host. After that, I am adding some syntax. Okay. Here, in define host. In the define host, you have to go to the host name. This is the host name. Okay, I am having the host name as system. Okay, client. HTML tutorial client, and the IP address also you have to define. What is the IP address of our client, or whatever the server will be there. Okay, 105 is there, and the host name is system admin tutorial hyphen client. So go to our Nagios server. Okay, system admin tutorial hyphen client is there. Okay, and here also in the service part also you have to change the host name, that is okay. And this is the check command main ping with 100%, and the time is everything is defined. Okay, so now I am save the file here. And now I have to restart the Nagios server. How will you restart? It is the init documents. Okay. Now, so check the it is running. So now we have restarted. Now we go to the browser. Okay. In the browser, we just refresh and go to the host. You see, here the two hosts are added. That is localhost and system admin tutorial client. Okay. So to server, if you want to add the number of routers, switch, or any other server, your web server, Apache server, NFS server, and everything you want, you can add by using this CSV file, that is the localhost.csv, or you can also create any file with the name of .csv. Okay, and you can change the path or give the path inside the which one, that is nagios.csv file. What is the configuration file of the Nagios? That is the user local Nagios etc, then Nagios.csv. Inside that you can change the file name where you are putting all your host names. Okay, you can see this is the up, and up time is, what is the up time? Only 19 seconds. And in the local host, what is the up time of the local host? That is 11 minutes 32 seconds. Okay, so ping is okay and packet loss is, no packet loss is there. Okay, so everything we have done everything successfully and our Nagios server is working properly. So you just follow all the steps whatever I have done, and if you want the complete note, then the steps are already there in our tutorial, that is system admin tutorial. You go to the site, system admin tutorial, this is the site. Okay, from there you just go to the search bar, and in the search bar you search Nagios. Okay, the Nagios, once you search, you will find how to install and configure Nagios on Ubuntu also is there. Okay, so in Ubuntu only you have to change the installation command, that is instead of using yum you have to use apt and service restart. In that is some of the OS commands will vary, otherwise all the processes are same. Okay, thank you for watching.